The 1990 Marvel Universe trading card set is fondly remembered by Marvel fans. At 162 cards, it was the largest Marvel card set at that time, and it had high production values, making it very collectible. You could assemble the set by purchasing packs or boxes. With 12 cards per pack and 36 packs per box, you were mathematically able to complete at least two sets per box. A collector's binder was also available by mail-in offer for $20. The set was broken into seven subsets: superheroes, supervillains, rookies, which were defined as the superheroes that had new comic titles in 1990, famous battles, most valuable cards, team pictures, and Spider-Man presents, where Spidey interviews different Marvel characters. Five hologram cards were also randomly inserted into packs. We're proud to present the 1990 Marvel Universe card set. Enjoy! During the most desperate hours of World War II, a frail, young man named Steve Rogers volunteered for a dangerous experiment. Ingesting the top-secret super soldier serum, he became Captain America, the living symbol of freedom. His body now physically perfect, his fighting skills now without equal, Cap joined the war against the Nazis and contributed greatly to the Allied powers' eventual victory. Today, he continues the tradition as he fights to defend America against all those forces that would threaten her. Did you know Captain America was frozen in a block of ice in the Arctic for over a decade before the superhero team known as the Avengers rescued him? While he fought in the secret wars on another planet, Spider-Man's original costume was destroyed. An alien machine made this new black costume to replace it. Although it possessed built-in web shooters and allowed him to change his clothes with but a thought, Spidey was forced to abandon it when he discovered that it was actually an alien symbiote that wanted to take over his body. Since then, he occasionally wears an identical costume that he made from cloth. Did you know Spider-Man's alien black costume is now worn by his archenemy Venom? While working at a nuclear research facility, scientist Bruce Banner was accidentally caught in a gamma bomb explosion. The blast transformed him into the monstrous, rampaging Hulk, a creature with childlike intelligence and superhuman strength. He can lift over 100 tons when enraged, which he often directs against those who would threaten him or other innocent beings. Ever since, when enraged, Banner turns into the Hulk and stays that way until the raging giant calms down and reverts back to his normal human form. Did you know the Hulk can easily jump over 3 miles in one leap? As a result of an accident that involved a radioactive isotope when he was a teenager, Daredevil lost his sight, but all his other senses were enhanced to incredible superhuman levels. He also gained his amazing radar sense, which in most ways, more than makes up for his blindness. With his superior athletic ability, Daredevil takes risks that most people who can see what they're doing wouldn't dare take. Did you know Daredevil doesn't need a lie detector to tell if someone is lying? He can just tune in his hearing to the person's heartbeat to listen for sudden jumps in its rate. Having established a reputation as a brave and fearless soldier during World War II, Nick Fury was chosen to head SHIELD, the Strategic Hazard Intervention Espionage Logistics Directorate, in its mission to detect and destroy covert threats to the democratic way of life. With his vast combat experience, technical know-how, and fighting prowess, this tough-talking, hard-hitting super spy is more than a match for just about any opponent he faces. Did you know Nick Fury regularly ingests the top-secret Infinity Formula to maintain his youth and vigor? Exposure to cosmic rays on a space mission turned the normal-looking Ben Grimm into the monstrous thing. Although he hasn't been too happy whenever he's looked in the mirror since then, he now has superhuman strength. He can lift over 85 tons, and is virtually invulnerable, which just goes to prove that beauty isn't everything. Did you know the Thing's most persistent and annoying foes are the Yancey Street Gang, a group of street toughs who've been tormenting the big guy for years by pulling the most outrageous practical jokes on him? Realizing that normal humans would fear mutants like himself, Professor X built a school to teach mutants how to use their superhuman powers safely, and founded the X-Men. He possesses the most powerful telepathic mind known to man, which he uses to lead the X-Men and combat evil mutants all over the world. Did you know Professor X's stepbrother is none other than the unstoppable Juggernaut? Cyclops has the mutant ability to fire powerful blasts of energy from his eyes with pinpoint accuracy. For many years, he was the valiant leader of the Uncanny X-Men. Now, he heads the group of mutants known as X-Factor. Although he loved Marvel Girl for many years, he eventually married a woman named Madeline Pryor. Unfortunately, their marital bliss came to a bizarre and violent end when she eventually became his most implacable foe, the Sorceress Goblin Queen. Did you know if it weren't for his ruby quartz goggles, Cyclops's optic blasts would emanate uncontrollably every time he opened his eyes? Marvel Girl is a mutant who has the mind-boggling ability of telekinesis, which allows her to manipulate any object by just thinking about moving it. When you add to that her power to zap anyone who even looks at her funny with a blast of pure mental energy, you have one woman who knows how to take care of herself in even the most dangerous situations. Did you know an evil alien life form assumed Marvel Girl's appearance and took her place for over a year, and no one, not even her best friends, realized it at the time? Savage, unpredictable, unstoppable, all of these words describe the man known as Wolverine. He is without a doubt the most formidable member of the X-Men, and, some would say, the most loyal as well. His razor-sharp claws and his ferocious attitude make his enemies think twice about crossing him, and those that do cross him rarely get the chance to repeat their mistake. Did you know Wolverine possesses a built-in healing factor that allows him to recover from even the most severe wounds in an amazingly short time? Phoenix is from an alternate future timeline in which mutants like herself have been ruthlessly eradicated by the robotic sentinels. She came back to our era in order to prevent her future from ever happening. Connected to the fundamental life force of the universe, Phoenix commands incalculable telekinetic power, which she can release as a shattering blast of energy or use to reconfigure the molecular structure of any substance. Did you know Phoenix's parents are the mutants known as Cyclops and Marvel Girl? Framed for a crime he didn't commit, Luke Cage volunteered to be a guinea pig in a scientific experiment in order to win his release from prison. The experiment gave him phenomenal strength, he can lift 3 tons, and impervious, steel-hard skin. Now, as Power Man, he uses his fantastic powers to help those in need while he searches for evidence to clear his good name. Did you know Power Man takes on most of his cases as a hero for hire in the employ of a client? Dazzler possesses the mutant ability to transmute sound into radiant bursts of light. She can project anything from a luminescent stream of brilliant colors to a laser beam of titanic force. Although her first love is her career as a singer, Dazzler is never hesitant about using her remarkable abilities to enlighten evildoers as to the error of their ways. Did you know as good as Dazzler is with her light powers, there are some who would say she is even better at roller skating? Tandy Bowen was a teenage runaway who arrived in New York City and was quickly kidnapped by criminal drug manufacturers. Injected with an experimental drug, Tandy unexpectedly acquired the amazing power to create light knives, which she can use to drain the energy from her enemies or cure people afflicted by drugs or poisons. Taking the name Dagger, this heroine has since devoted herself to wiping out the scourge of illegal drugs that pervades today's world. Did you know Dagger is the only person capable of traveling in her partner Cloak's dimension of darkness without suffering any ill effects, other than Cloak, of course? Quasar is the latest in a series of protectors of the universe beings entrusted by the cosmic entity known as Ian with the guardianship of civilized life throughout the cosmos. His amazing quantum bands allow him to create solid objects out of pure energy and to survive in the vacuum of outer space. Quasar is without question one of the most powerful heroes on the scene today. Did you know unbeknown to the Fantastic Four, Quasar operates out of 4 Freedoms Plaza, the FF's headquarters? Prince Namor the Submariner is the super-powered heir to the throne of the undersea kingdom of legendary Atlantis. At times a friend and at others a foe of land-dwelling humans, this hot-tempered monarch has on occasion led his Atlantean hordes in wars of vengeance against the surface world to combat mankind's polluting ways. More recently, he's left Atlantis to use his might, his wisdom, and his vast wealth to fight polluters, using the corporate boardrooms of the surface world as his battlefield. Did you know even though Namor can breathe both water and air, the longer he is out of water, the more his super strength fades? After an unsuccessful attempt to cure himself from transforming into the Green Hulk whenever he became enraged, Bruce Banner started becoming a different man-like creature instead. Now, whenever night falls, he changes into a gray-skinned Hulk who's more sinister and destructive than the Green Hulk had ever been. Though not as strong as the Green Hulk, he could now lift only 70 tons. The Grey Hulk combines guile and cunning with sheer brute force to more than make up for the loss. Did you know the Grey Hulk was employed for a while as the enforcer for a Las Vegas casino? Renowned as the bravest and most noble of his kind, Thor is the legendary Norse god of thunder. Having journeyed to Earth from Asgard, fabled home of the gods, Thor lends both his tremendous strength, he can lift over 100 tons, and his invincible URU hammer Mjolnir toward the cause of honor and justice. Did you know when Thor transforms into his earthly identity of Erik Masterson by stamping his hammer once upon the ground, the hammer itself transforms into a cane? While on a space mission aboard an experimental rocket of his own design, the brilliant scientist Reed Richards was bombarded by cosmic rays. The radiation gave him the amazing ability to change his body into any shape imaginable. No wonder that he took the name Mr. Fantastic. Since then, he has used his powers and his genius to defend Earth from the most powerful, most evil, and most bizarre supervillains the world has ever known. Did you know Mr. Fantastic's uniform is composed of unstable molecules, which allow it to change shape as he does? As heir to the throne of the African nation of Wakanda, T'Challa was also heir to the powers of the sacred panther totem. By ingesting a secret formula made from mystic tropical herbs, his natural strength, speed and agility were phenomenally enhanced, and he learned to track and stalk as well as any jungle cat. Now, as the Black Panther, he is an internationally renowned hero and the protector of his people. Did you know as King of Wakanda, the Black Panther is the only Avenger who rules a nation? With his metallic wings, Archangel can soar faster than the speed of sound. And with a thought, the high-flying mutant can use them to shoot armor-ripping razor darts laced with a paralyzing neurotoxin. But his awesome powers come with an awful price. If he's not careful, he'll lapse into a berserker rage and attack both friend and foe alike with lethal ferocity. Did you know after his own mutant wings were destroyed in the aftermath of a brutal battle, Archangel was given his new metal wings by the merciless villain known as Apocalypse? The frosty, fun-loving mutant known as Iceman has the amazing ability to freeze the moisture in the air around him into ice and shape it into almost any form he desires. One of his favorite tricks is to create an ice slide beneath his feet and ride it through the air. Without a doubt, Iceman is the coolest superhero around. Did you know Iceman's powers have recently gotten so out of control that he must wear a special belt to contain them? Not much is known about the true origins of the mutant called Wolverine. He was found in the Canadian wilderness, living as a savage, untamed beast. At some point in the past, his skeleton was laced with unbreakable adamantium, and adamantium claws were installed in his forearms. It was while wearing this costume that Wolverine joined the X-Men. Though later educated in the ways of modern society, his personality is still a reflection of the savage life he once led. Did you know before he joined the X-Men, Wolverine worked as a top Canadian secret agent? Storm has the mutant power to completely control the weather. She can whip up a lightning and thunder, hurricane force downpour with less effort than most people use to tie their shoelaces. And she can fly by riding the wind. With her nerves of steel and her forceful personality, it is no surprise that Storm is the current leader of the X-Men. Did you know Storm suffers from acute claustrophobia? Shadowcat has the mutant power known as phasing. She can become intangible and pass through any solid object. She can use this power to disrupt electric circuits and program computers by physically entering them. Although she can be as goofy and prone to infatuation as most girls her age, this teenager shows a maturity beyond her years in high-pressure situations. Did you know Shadowcat's natural state is intangibility? It's only by concentration and training that she can keep herself in a solid state. Mark Spector made his living by taking jobs as a mercenary around the globe. While working in Egypt, Spector was shot and left for dead by one of his fellow soldiers. But he miraculously recovered, believing that he had been resurrected by Khonshu, the Egyptian god of the moon, to serve as his avenging agent on Earth. Renouncing his mercenary ways, Spectre went forth as Moon Knight to deliver Khonshu's justice to criminals around the world. Did you know Moon Knight's strength increases and decreases with the phases of the moon? Lockheed is the alien pet dragon of the mutant known as Shadowcat. Discovered by her during a mission in space, Lockheed formed an immediate and lasting attachment to the teenage girl and returned with her to Earth. With his abilities to fly and breathe flame, he has more than enough power to cause anyone who might threaten his young master to think twice. Did you know no one, not even Shadowcat, knows which planet Lockheed comes from? May Parker is the loving aunt of Peter Parker, better known to the world as the Amazing Spider-Man. After Peter's parents were killed, May and her husband, Ben Parker, took Peter into their home and raised him like their own son, instilling in him strong moral values. Although Spider-Man no longer lives with his aunt, May Parker still serves as a constant inspiration to the wall crawler. Did you know despite all the years Aunt May has known Peter Parker, she isn't aware that he's Spider-Man and is, in fact, terrified of the web-slinging superhero? Peter Parker became Spider-Man by accident. He was bitten by a radioactive spider during a science demonstration. He gained superhuman strength, he can lift over 10 tons, super agility, the ability to stick to walls, his amazing, danger-detecting spider sense, and the realization that with great power comes great responsibility. Ever since, Spidey has used his powers to bring hundreds of criminals, from the most common car thieves to the most sinister supervillains, to justice. Did you know the webs that Spidey spins out of his web shooters are a secret formula of his own creation? Recently, Spider-Man was granted cosmic powers by the mysterious Enigma Force so that he could combat the Tri-Sentinel, a giant robotic creature that menaced the entire world. As the cosmic Spidey, he could fly, had virtually unlimited strength, and could form his webbing into any shape by mental force alone. Once the Tri-Sentinel had been defeated, however, Spider-Man's cosmic powers disappeared as well. Did you know with his cosmic powers, Spider-Man was the strongest superhero in the Marvel Universe? Captain America's standard mode of transportation is his custom-designed motorcycle, which was a gift from a grateful fan whose life Cap had saved. Built to ride on the roughest roads, it can get Cap to the scene of any disaster in minutes, regardless of the terrain. Cap stores his motorcycle in his mobile van headquarters. Did you know Captain America first rode a motorcycle overseas during World War II? Once the herald of the planet-devouring being known as Galactus, the Silver Surfer eventually rebelled against his former master. Since then, he has been cruising the spaceways on his indestructible board to use his cosmic spawn powers for the benefit of beings in need across the universe. He has incredible strength, he can lift well over 100 tons, and he can shoot explosive bolts of pure energy from his hands. Did you know the Silver Surfer does not need to eat or breathe? He absorbs everything he needs to live through his skin in the form of cosmic energy. This hot-headed hero got his searing superpowers from exposure to cosmic rays while on an experimental space mission. Ever since, he's used his ability to flame on and shoot fire from his body to make life uncomfortably hot for supervillains everywhere. The high-temperature, high-flying Human Torch is easily the most sizzling superhero in the Marvel Universe. Did you know the Human Torch is married to Alicia Masters, the former longtime girlfriend of his fellow FF teammate, The Thing? As Sorcerer Supreme, Doctor Strange has at his command a vast assortment of powerful magicka. Spells, which he uses to combat any evil supernatural beings who would use their dark powers to threaten the Earth. Based in his Sanctum Sanctorum, and with the help of his all-seeing Orb of Agamotto, his Cloak of Levitation, and his Eye of Agamotto amulet, he is the mystic guardian of our world. Did you know Doctor Strange received his magical training from a Tibetan mystic known as the Ancient One? Havok has the mutant power to project concentrated blasts of charged plasma energy enough to shatter a mountainside. But his power is so uncontrollable that he must wear his special costume to channel it safely. Although he prefers living a normal life over superheroing, Havok recently rejoined the X-Men after his lover, Polaris, was turned into the vengeance-seeking Malice by the mutant-hating Marauders. Did you know Havok's brother is none other than the former X-Men and present X-Factor leader known as Cyclops? Born and raised on a collective farm in the Soviet Union, Colossus discovered that he had the mutant ability to transform his body into invincible organic steel. In his armored form, Colossus possesses enormous strength, he can lift 70 tons, and near limitless stamina. His gentle, soft-spoken manner is a sharp contrast to the tremendous physical power at his command. Did you know when he's not fighting supervillains, Colossus uses his free time to pursue his favorite pastime painting? When Wolverine feels he must simply cut loose and get away from his X-Men teammates, he journeys to the city of Madripoor in Southeast Asia. There, he goes by a different identity patch in his pursuit of pleasure and relaxation. But his vacations typically turn into brawls with the local crime lords and drug czars, which, for a guy like Wolverine, is about as much fun as he can ever hope to have. Did you know Wolverine's healing factor slows his aging? He is already over 80 years old. Easily the most bizarre-looking mutant hero, the German-born Nightcrawler, has one of the strangest superpowers as well. He can instantaneously teleport himself over distances of up to 3 miles. Each jump is accompanied by an audible bamf sound and the nauseating stench of brimstone. Add to that his incredible acrobatic skills, and the happy-go-lucky Nightcrawler is more than a match for almost any evildoer. Did you know before Professor X recruited him for his first superhero team, the X-Men, Nightcrawler was the star performer of a Bavarian circus? After getting a blood transfusion from her cousin, Bruce Banner, also known as the Hulk, Jen Walters acquired the ability to transform into the sensational She-Hulk and quickly learned to love her new identity. Now she's the She-Hulk all the time, and she's anything but shy about showing off her chartreuse complexion, her fabulously muscled figure and her superhuman strength. She can bench press 75 tons. Did you know She-Hulk gets around in a lime green 59 Dodge convertible, which she had specially customized, so it can fly as well as drive? Captain Britain was selected by the sorcerer Merlin to become the embodiment of the spirit of Great Britain. His strength was mystically augmented to a phenomenal degree, he can lift up to 2 tons, and he can fly as well. Although somewhat hot-headed and stubborn, Captain Britain personifies the noblest qualities of the legendary Knights of the Round Table. Did you know Captain Britain's powers derive from England itself? Away from his homeland, his might is considerably reduced. Rogue has the mutant ability to temporarily absorb the powers of others with but a touch, which allows her to use her enemies' strengths against them and makes her the most versatile member of the X-Men. She can also fly and has super strength. She can lift up to 50 tons, powers she permanently absorbed from the original Ms. Marvel. Did you know Rogue must always wear a full body suit to prevent her from accidentally absorbing the memories and powers of those around her? Iron Man gets his fantastic powers from his suit of micromesh armor. It gives him superhuman strength. He can lift up to 100 tons at peak operating capacity, the ability to fly via his jet boots, and a variety of built-in weapons, foremost among these being his devastating repulsor rays. Iron Man is dedicated to defeating those forces that would threaten the security of the nation and the entire world. Did you know as multi-millionaire industrialist Tony Stark, Iron Man provides funds to repair the damage caused by superhero/supervillain battles? Exposure to cosmic rays while on a space mission gave Sue Storm the abilities to become invisible at will, to turn anything nearby invisible, and to create invisible force fields and other invisible objects that can be used as weapons. Now a superheroine whose courage is apparent even when she isn't, she is also married to Mr. Fantastic and is the sister of the Human Torch. Did you know the Invisible Woman frequently changes her hairstyle? An interesting passion considering that most people don't see her long enough to appreciate it. The Punisher's battle van is a veritable mobile fortress. It contains a wide variety of built-in offensive weapons and is heavily armored against any sort of attack. Its built-in computer and surveillance equipment allow the Punisher to gather information about a suspect at a moment's notice. When he's out on a mission, the Punisher considers his battle van his home away from home. Did you know the Punisher's friend, the technical wizard known as Microchip, designed the weaponry and armor for the Punisher's battle van? Longshot is a synthetic humanoid created to serve as a slave in the entertainment industry of Mojo, an extra-dimensional tyrant. But Longshot escaped, and now uses the abilities Mojo gave him to combat his former master. Longshot has the unpredictable power of fabulous luck. Combined with his amazing agility, this power allows him to perform acrobatic stunts considered impossible. As long as his motives are pure, the odds are always on his side. Did you know Longshot has only 3 fingers and a thumb on each hand? The beast possesses all of the strength, speed and agility of a jungle gorilla, and is just as furry too. This happy-go-lucky mutant can lift up to a ton, and can find a sure foothold on even the smoothest surfaces. Despite his appearance, the Beast conceals beneath his brutish exterior the mind of a brilliant scientist. Did you know after taking an untested chemical mixture, which reacted with his mutant cell structure, the Beast became the blue and furry hero he is today? After his family was murdered by mobsters, Marine Corps Captain Frank Castle decided to take the law into his own hands and became the vengeance-crazed vigilante known as the Punisher. Now, this grim, merciless one-man war on crime employs his vast arsenal of weapons to dispense his own lethal brand of justice, the kind that comes out of the barrel of a gun. Did you know, like the criminals he hunts, the Punisher is himself a fugitive from the law? During the period when she wore this outfit, Storm's mutant power to control the weather was accidentally destroyed by the mutant inventor Forge. Despite her loss, Storm continued to lead the X-Men, relying on her daring and wits in her ongoing struggle against evil, and proving that it was never her superpowers that made her a hero, but her courage. Did you know before she joined the X-Men, Storm was worshipped as a goddess by certain African tribes? After her father was killed by terrorists, Elektra was taken in by the Hand, a ruthless band of ninjas, and taught the skills of a professional assassin. But she rebelled against her teachers, and now uses her deadly ninja skills to attack the Hand around the globe. Her astounding abilities in all forms of hand-to-hand combat make her an almost unbeatable foe. Did you know the supervillain Bullseye killed Elektra, but she was brought back to life through the heroic efforts of Daredevil? Captured by illegal drug manufacturers while a runaway teenager, Tyrone Johnson became the subject of a grisly experiment. An untested new designer drug that he was injected with unexpectedly turned him into Cloak, a being who needs to absorb the light energy of human souls to survive. Cloak can teleport over vast distances, and his body acts as a portal to the sinister dark dimension. Cloak now uses these powers to take his revenge on drug dealers all over the world. Did you know Cloak's hunger for the light energy of human souls can only be controlled by his partner Dagger's light powers? The Winsome Wasp has the power to shrink herself to the size of the flying insect for which she is named. At that size, wings sprout from her back, allowing this tiny heroine to fly. She also has use of her wasp sting. She fires devastating blasts of bioelectric energy from her hands. Don't let her small size fool you. One sting from the Wasp is enough to knock out all but the most powerful opponents. Did you know the Wasp has the largest assortment of costumes of any superhero? It's a rarity for her to wear the same outfit twice. The Kingpin controls the mob families of New York City, and his criminal influence extends up and down much of the East Coast. No major crime in the New York area goes down without his knowledge and approval. Although he prefers to keep a safe distance from legal authorities and superheroes alike by hiring others to do his dirty work, his impressive strength and surprising agility guarantee that he can deal effectively with just about anyone who challenges him. Did you know most people mistakenly believe that the Kingpin's bulk is all fat, when in fact, it is all muscle? The current Baron Zemo began his criminal career after his father, the first Baron Zemo, perished in a battle with Captain America. A brilliant strategist and tactician, Zemo has sworn to use his military cunning to destroy the Star-Spangled Avenger. Did you know Baron Zemo constantly wears his red hood to conceal his horribly scarred face? Loki is the adopted son of Odin, ruler of the Asgardian gods. Jealous of the love Odin feels for his true son, Thor, Loki devotes his immortal existence to plotting the destruction of his noble stepbrother. Occasionally, he even tries to overthrow his father. With his vast knowledge of sorcery and cruel cunning, Loki truly lives up to his title as the god of evil. Did you know an evil plot by Loki to use the Hulk to destroy Thor was the reason for the formation of the superhero team known as the Mighty Avengers? Nothing can stop the Juggernaut. No force on Earth has yet been found that can bring this lumbering, bludgeoning behemoth to a halt once he starts moving. After gaining his awesome strength from a mystical gem, he spent most of his misguided criminal career seeking revenge against Professor X, founder of the superhero team the X-Men. Did you know the man Juggernaut hates most, Professor X, is also his stepbrother? Nightmare is the terrifying tyrant who rules the dream dimension, the plane of existence through which human minds pass while they sleep. Not content with his domination of the world of the unconscious, Nightmare eagerly awaits the day when he can conquer the waking world as well. If not for the vigilance of Doctor Strange, this malignant sorceress entity might have already succeeded. Did you know Nightmare roams the uncharted expanse of his dream realm on a demonic black horse? Superhuman endurance, heightened senses, superior strength, and agility, all these attributes make the mutant Sabretooth the best in his business, and his business is assassination. What makes this nasty guy even nastier are his claws sharp enough to cut through a man like a knife cutting through warm butter. Over the years, he and Wolverine have fought a series of epic, blood-crazed battles. So far, neither one has emerged as a clear winner. Sabretooth is one cat whose path you don't ever want to cross. Did you know Sabretooth has the same fast healing power as Wolverine? Electro is a human dynamo. He has the ability to instantaneously generate up to 100,000 volts of electricity. Ever since he gained his power in a freak lightning storm, he has used his awesome energies exclusively for criminal purposes. Unfortunately for him, but fortunately for law-abiding society, Spider-Man has more often than not pulled the plug on this electrified evildoer. Did you know Electro can use his power to override and control any electrically powered device? While engaged in dangerous experiments, Dr. Otto Octavius accidentally triggered an explosion that permanently grafted onto his body the mechanical arms he was using to handle radioactive material. Now, as the master criminal known as Dr. Octopus, he feels that too many have ridiculed his scientific work, and so he uses his titanic tentacles, they can lift up to 3 tons, an evil genius to take revenge on the world. Did you know Dr. Octopus can instantaneously maneuver and extend his artificial arms with but a thought? Being the ruler of the tiny Balkan nation of Latveria isn't enough for Dr. Doom, he wants to rule the whole world. In pursuit of this goal, the power-hungry monarch has built countless weapons and robots and designed his suit of armor to be a self-contained, nuclear-powered arsenal. He is unquestionably the most brilliant evil genius alive today. Did you know to hide his horribly disfigured face, Dr. Doom never removes his mask in anyone's presence? During an experiment in artificial intelligence, the Avenger known as Henry Pym accidentally created the evil robotic being known as Ultron. Intent on improving himself to the ultimate degree, Ultron reconstructed his body using an impervious adamantium alloy, and then embarked on a crusade to destroy all organic life forms. If not for the Avengers, Ultron might have already succeeded in achieving his ghastly goal. Did you know Ultron is responsible for the creation of the android Avenger known as the Vision? Her ravishing beauty only serves to disguise the festering evil that hides within this immortal. A sorceress of great power and strength from legendary Asgard, the Enchantress can make any man she kisses a starry-eyed, love-stricken slave to her will. But of all the men that she's used her spellbindingly seductive charms on through the ages, the one she has always desired most is the one who has always escaped her grasp, the mighty Thor, God of Thunder. Did you know Thor is the only man who ever stood up the Enchantress on a date? Magneto is the mutant master of magnetism. His awesome ability to exert absolute control over all objects subject to magnetic forces makes him perhaps the most dangerous man on Earth. And if he succeeds in his insane plan to protect the mutant race, Homo Superior, from normal humans by conquering all of non-mutant mankind, he'll become the most powerful man on Earth as well. Did you know Magneto is the father of Avengers Quicksilver and the Scarlet Witch, two superheroes who once were members of their dad's Brotherhood of Evil Mutants? Bullseye is a merciless master assassin who'll accept a contract on anyone if the price is right. He has the amazing talent of turning almost any object into a lethal weapon. And he's an astonishingly accurate marksman. When Bullseye takes aim, he never misses. Did you know Bullseye's skeleton is reinforced with adamantium, just like the mutant hero Wolverine? Not much is known about the evil mastermind who calls himself Mr. Sinister. His agents, the Marauders, mercilessly carry out his ongoing war against all mutants for his own mysterious purposes. He possesses titanic strength and formidable mental abilities, and is tremendously resistant to injury. But the true extent of his powers remains a mystery. Mr. Sinister is undoubtedly the most enigmatic evil force ever faced by the X-Men and X-Factor. Did you know using some unknown means, Mr. Sinister can resurrect his Marauder henchmen after they have been killed? Caught in a nuclear blast while hiding from the law on a testing range, William Baker underwent an amazing transformation when his body fused with the sand beneath his feet. Now, as the Sandman, he can change into anything from a blinding sandstorm to a crushing concrete slab. In his stone-like form, he can lift up to 85 tons. Superheroes know that a battle with the savage Sandman is no day at the beach. Did you know the Sandman's greatest nemesis is water? When wet, his body becomes soggy and impossible to manipulate. While working on a way to regrow his lost arm, Dr. Kurt Connors injected himself with a serum derived from the glands of a reptile. His missing limb did grow back, but the serum mutated him into a fearsome, man-sized, human-hating lizard. Now, with his raging reptilian strength, he can lift 12 tons, and his total command of his fellow reptiles, the lizard is dedicated to wiping out humanity so that reptiles can rule the earth, and he can be their king. Did you know, although the lizard is one of Spider-Man's greatest foes, his alter ego, Kurt Connors, is one of Spidey's closest friends? Shunned by humanity due to his ugly appearance, the man who would come to be called the Mole Man hid deep beneath the surface of the earth. There, he came to rule a realm called Subterranea and enslave its semi-humanoid inhabitants, the Subterraneans, to do his evil bidding. His thirst for vengeance drives him to lead his loyal followers in wars of conquest against the surface world. If not for the Fantastic Four's heroic efforts to stop him, he might already have won. Did you know, although nearly blind, the Mole Man possesses an uncanny radar sense which substitutes for his sight? The Dread Dormammu is a being of vast magical power from the mystical dark dimension, who devotes his demonic talents toward the conquest of our dimension. Only the heroic efforts of the Earth Sorcerer Doctor Strange and the Sorcerer Supreme, who were his predecessors, have prevented this evil entity from accomplishing his ghastly goal. Did you know Dormammu is the uncle of the Sorceress Clea, the longtime girlfriend of his archenemy, Doctor Strange? Exposure to gamma radiation gave the leader his phenomenal intellect. Convinced that his genius entitles him to rule the world, he's unleashed scheme after scheme to bend the human race to his will. With but a touch, the leader can dominate the minds of those whose intelligence is less than his, turning them into his obedient slaves. It is ironic that the leader's plans have so often been thwarted by the mindless brute known as the Hulk. Did you know the leader began his criminal career as a spy for a hostile foreign power? The obese blob has the mutant ability to become absolutely immovable when he so chooses. He has fantastic strength and his fat-laden form is immune to almost all physical harm. He uses his malicious might as a member of Freedom Force, the corrupt government-backed task force whose job it is to detain any mutant considered a threat to the United States. Did you know, before joining his first super-powered group, the Brotherhood of Evil Mutants, the Blob worked as a featured attraction in a traveling carnival? Following in her father's footsteps, the beautiful black cat trained to become the greatest sneak thief of all. After years of dedicated work, she now has all the speed and agility of her namesake, skills that she uses to steal fabulous riches for herself. For a time, she seemed to have reformed and was acting as Spider-Man's partner. But you can't teach an old cat new tricks, as the black cat has since returned to her life of crime. Did you know Spider-Man is determined to put the Black Cat in prison for her crimes, and Black Cat is equally determined to make Spider-Man fall in love with her? Eddie Brock was a reporter whose career collapsed when Spider-Man brought in the real perpetrator of a crime Eddie had claimed to have solved. Finding Spider-Man's alien black costume, Brock merged with it and became the maniacal Venom, the web-slinger's opposite number. Venom has all of the same spider-like powers as Spidey, and uses those powers in an attempt to destroy the man whom he believes ruined his life, Spider-Man. Did you know the costume that Venom wears is a living evil alien entity? The most recent Green Goblin, Harry Osborn, is the son of the first Green Goblin, the late Norman Osborn. But no matter who has assumed the role, this super-villain has always been one of Spider-Man's most dangerous foes. Riding his amazing jet glider and armed with an assortment of pumpkin bombs, the Green Goblin has been a living nightmare for Spidey almost from the time the wall crawler spun his first web. Did you know, ironically, Harry Osborn is a longtime friend of Peter Parker, otherwise known as Spider-Man? One of the most powerful cosmic beings in existence, Galactus must consume the energy from entire planets in order to survive. Driven by his insatiable hunger, his arrival in a star system signals the end of life for all who dwell within it. Only the combined might of the Fantastic Four and the Silver Surfer was enough to prevent Galactus from making the Earth his latest meal. Did you know the star-spanning hero known as the Silver Surfer once served as Galactus's herald? The Mandarin discovered 10 rings of power within the ruins of a crashed spaceship that he found in his native China. The rings give him a vast array of devastating abilities, everything from a blinding black light ray to a power beam of irresistible force. The Mandarin's rings make this evil mastermind one of the greatest threats to the Western world in existence today. Did you know the Mandarin is a master of the martial arts? A brilliant genetic scientist, the high evolutionary seeks ways to evolve mankind into higher forms of life. His early experiments on animals brought forth the Knights of Wundagore, fearsome animal men embodying the best and worst traits of their species. Although the high evolutionary's motives are good, his experiments invariably wreak havoc on the world. Did you know the high evolutionary has managed to evolve himself to a higher plane of consciousness, giving him cosmic awareness? Mephisto is the physical manifestation of ultimate evil, the malefic master of the dimension that many refer to as hell. He thrives on greed and hate, and devotes his immortal existence to tricking unwitting humans into giving up their souls for eternity to his fiery domain. Although he has awesome supernatural powers, he prefers to lure mortals to their doom by tempting them with those things which they desire most. When you play his game, you bet your life. Did you know, although thought by many to be the same being as the biblical devil, Mephisto is not, and makes no such claim. Thanos is a worshipper of death. This demigod from Saturn's moon Titan seeks to make the ultimate sacrificial offering to his beloved deity. From his immense spaceship, Sanctuary 2, he plots the destruction of intelligent life throughout the universe. He possesses almost incalculable cosmic power, but it is his cunning and evil mind that make him as dangerous a menace as he is. Did you know Thanos is responsible for the death of the hero known as Adam Warlock? Apocalypse believes that only the strong survive, and that the weak must be destroyed. In his quest to weed out those he deems unfit to live, he manipulates various factions of mutants to battle each other to the death. Apocalypse himself is a formidable foe with the ability to alter his molecular structure in any way, but he prefers to sit on the sidelines and watch as others engage in battles of his devising. Did you know Apocalypse's former headquarters, a massive sentient starship, now serves as the headquarters for his archenemies, the superhero group known as X-Factor? Trained by Adolf Hitler to be the living embodiment of the Nazi cause, the merciless Red Skull cut a deadly swath of terror throughout World War II. During a battle with Captain America, he was subjected to a gas that put him into a state of suspended animation. Surviving into the present, the Skull continues his bloody war on humanity. He will not rest until he has created a new Fourth Reich with himself as its all-powerful Führer. Did you know, although he originally wore a skull-like mask, exposure to his own deadly dust of death caused the Red Skull's face to become a literal red skull? After finding a mysterious motorcycle in a cemetery, teenager Danny Ketch gained the power to transform himself into Ghost Rider, a flaming skeletal being of great strength and even greater purpose. In his fiery new identity, he is the living spirit of vengeance. His sole reason for being is to punish those who would harm the innocent. He's easily the hottest new hero of 1990. Did you know Danny Ketch becomes Ghost Rider by touching his mystical motorcycle? When research scientist Michael Collins learned that his employer, the Mammoth Roxon Corporation, was building the ultimate killing machine in the form of a cyborg, he tried to put a stop to it. Instead, Harlan Ryker, the project's director, had Collins's brain removed from his body and put in the cyborg, and Collins became Deathlok, a super-strong, plasma pistol-packing living engine of pure destruction. Driven by the burning desire to take revenge on those who made him the monster he is today, Deathlok is undoubtedly the most motivated new hero of 1990. Did you know Deathlok never needs change to make a phone call? He can just shove his computerized finger into a phone jack and hook up with anywhere in the world. In the early 31st century, the Earth will be conquered by the ruthless reptilian alien race known as the Badun. At that time, the Guardians of the Galaxy, each member the last survivor of his or her respective race, join forces in an effort to liberate our planet from its new extraterrestrial overlords. Eventually, the valiant team of heroes succeeds and decides to remain together to defend the Earth from any further threats that might attack it from outer space. Did you know Major Vance Astro's younger self on present-day Earth is Marvel Boy of the New Warriors? Spurned or ignored by established superheroes because of their young age, Namorita, Firestar, Marvel Boy, Nova, and Speedball joined forces with the mysterious Night Thrasher to become the New Warriors, a super team with a difference. Their mission is to combat those crimes and menaces other heroes never touch. What they lack in experience, the members of the hottest new team of 1990 more than make up for with their youthful enthusiasm. Headquarters Ambrose Building. Did you know Marvel Boy's older future self is Vance Astro of the Guardians of the Galaxy? Nomad believes that America's morals are on a downward slide and has dedicated himself to fighting all those forces responsible for the decline. Firm in his convictions, he wanders the country in his quest for justice. He's easily the most upstanding new hero of 1990. Did you know Nomad received his physical training and learned his fighting skills from as good a teacher as anyone can hope for Captain America? Inspired by Greg Salinger, the second Fool Killer, Kurt Gerhardt started corresponding with the incarcerated felon by mail and eventually adopted the guise of Fool Killer himself. This Fool Killer considers it his sacred mission to destroy those people who do not lead a poetic existence in his eyes. Failure to measure up to his harsh standards results in total disintegration at the point of his purification gun. Fool Killer is undoubtedly the most demanding, and perhaps most insane, new hero of 1990. Did you know Kurt Gerhardt is the third individual to take on the mantle of the Fool Killer? In an attempt to take revenge on the New York-based superteam known as the Avengers, the Hulk was tearing up Manhattan. Only the Thing had a chance of stopping him and saving the city. But as powerful as he was, the Thing knew he was no match for the Hulk in a one-on-one slugfest. Instead, he applied a skillful, often desperate, combination of wit and muscle against the Green Goliath. Using everything from girders and buses to high-voltage power lines, the Thing slowed down the Hulk long enough for the Avengers and the rest of the Fantastic Four to finally join the battle and chase the Hulk away. The Silver Surfer had discovered that Earth possessed the energy his master, Galactus, needed to survive. The Surfer summoned the Galactus World Destroyer to New York City. There, the Surfer realized the wrongness of his actions and joined the Fantastic Four in their desperate attempt to stop Galactus. It was only with the aid of the mysterious alien called the Watcher that the FF got the only weapon that could stop Galactus, the Ultimate Nullifier. Defeated, Galactus left Earth. But to punish his former herald, he created an energy barrier around Earth, thus making it the Surfer's prison. Dr. Doom had stolen the Silver Surfer's power cosmic to use in conquering the world. No weapon on Earth could stop him. Even Doom's archenemies, the Fantastic Four, fell before his evil might. Out of desperation, Mr. Fantastic built the anti-cosmic flying wing to drain the cosmic energy from Doom. When Doom set out to destroy the robot craft, it led him to the edge of space, a barrier that Galactus, the Surfer's former master, had forbade the Surfer to pass. The impact sent Doom falling to Earth, stripped of his power and defeated. Surtur, the flame demon, was poised at the gates of Asgard, legendary home of the Norse gods. His plan was to thrust his Sword of Twilight into Asgard's eternal flame and create the ultimate weapon of destruction, which he would use to tear apart the very fabric of the universe. Thor summoned the power of a thousand suns and hurled it at Surtur. But Surtur mockingly turned that power against Thor and smashed his way into Asgard. The universe appeared doomed. But Thor, together with his half-brother Loki and their father Odin, launched a counterattack. Surtur was defeated, but Odin appeared to have been destroyed along with him. Kraven the Hunter confronted the fact that he was an old man. Refusing to quietly retire, he began his last hunt. His goal was twofold: he wanted to both defeat and become his archenemy Spider-Man. He tranquilized Spider-Man, then buried him, alive. While Spider-Man lay trapped in his coffin, Kraven, dressed as Spider-Man, launched a brutal war against criminals, eventually capturing the supervillain, Vermin. Spider-Man ultimately escaped and found Kraven. But before he could bring Kraven to justice, Kraven died, leaving a confession of all he had done. Dr. Octopus had committed the crime of the century. he had stolen the Defense Department's new weapon, the Nullifier. Even worse, Spider-Man had helped him, or so it appeared, after Doc Ock had used the device to rob Spidey of his memory and convince him that he, too, was a supervillain. But Octopus's plan to use Spider-Man as a criminal pawn ended when the two had a brutal falling out, which ended with the Nullifier back in the army's hands. Spider-Man escaped, but it was not until much later that he regained his memory. Bullseye had become the Kingpin's assassin, and a key player in the Kingpin's battle to regain control of all the New York City mobs. Daredevil vowed to stop the Kingpin and bring both him and Bullseye to justice. In a sub-basement of a skyscraper, Daredevil and Bullseye faced off for a final battle. At one point, Bullseye, who can turn any object into a lethal weapon, attempted to use Daredevil's own billy club to kill him. But Daredevil gained the upper hand and defeated Bullseye, sending him to jail. The Kingpin, however, remained free. Daredevil had broken into the Kingpin's secret vault, searching for evidence that would permanently put the overlord of crime in prison. But before Daredevil could finish the job, Kingpin discovered him and attacked, and eventually defeated him. Kingpin then had Daredevil bound in chains and thrown into a water main, certain that this would eliminate him. But Daredevil escaped. Vowing never to underestimate him again, Daredevil continued his quest to stop the Kingpin. From his extra-dimensional realm, Mephisto spied upon the Silver Surfer, a being whose utter nobility threatened the Lord of Darkness's dire quest to subjugate all mankind. He vowed to enlist the Surfer into his ranks, or destroy him. Mephisto used Shala Ball, the woman the Surfer had long loved, as bait to attract him to his realm. But his efforts to tempt the Surfer with wealth and power came to naught. The Surfer resisted. Mephisto finally attempted to absorb the Surfer's soul into his own. But its purity was too much for the evil Mephisto to take. Defeated, he finally released the Surfer and freed Shala Ball, vowing to crush his silver-skinned adversary next time. The evil Red Skull had stolen the most awesome weapon in the world, the Cosmic Cube, an energy device that could manipulate matter. Relishing his godlike power, the Red Skull repeatedly allowed Captain America to attack him. And each time, when Captain America was about to win, the Red Skull would use the Cosmic Cube to savagely strike him down. Finally, Captain America used the Red Skull's own arrogance as a weapon to defeat him and keep him from ever using the Cosmic Cube again. The evil mutant mastermind seized mental control of Phoenix and released her dark side in a plot to destroy her fellow X-Men. She became murderously uncontrollable. In an escalating wave of destruction, she assumed the identity of Dark Phoenix and annihilated a solar system. The Shuriar, an alien race, demanded that she be destroyed before she could do more damage. In a battle on the moon, the X-Men sought to defend her from the Shuriar's greatest warriors. Phoenix realized she truly was a menace far too dangerous to live. With a parting word of love to the X-Man Cyclops, she died, the willing victim of one of the battlefield's traps. The Avengers sought to bring Magneto, the mutant master of magnetism, before a world court tribunal to be tried for his crimes against humanity. The X-Men believed that if such a trial were held, Magneto would be lynched by a mutant-hating mob. In an attempt to save him, the X-Men fought the Avengers. But in the end he surrendered, hoping that by going to trial he would finally end mankind's anti-mutant prejudice. Magneto was acquitted, but the judgment only served to accelerate mankind's growing hatred for mutants. Visiting the Mutant Research Center on Muir Island, Wolverine, Banshee, Storm, Nightcrawler, and Colossus didn't realize that the X-Men's greatest foe, Magneto, had escaped his special prison cell in the complex. The mutant master of magnetism unleashed his near-limitless power and was about to destroy them when Cyclops arrived. The team's leader was the only X-Man who had experienced battling Magneto and was able to fight him to a standstill. Before Magneto could launch a new attack, the X-Men left for the US to save their mentor, Professor X, from an assassination attempt. Shadowcat was dying. The X-Men sought to save their teammate by asking Mr. Fantastic of the Fantastic Four for help. However, a series of misunderstandings turned the two groups against each other. To make matters worse, the evil Dr. Doom callously exploited the situation. Saving Shadowcat's life became a test of wills between Mr. Fantastic and Doom. Mr. Fantastic ultimately saved Shadowcat. In the end, the heroes learned that Dr. Doom had manipulated the crisis from the start in an attempt to destroy the Fantastic Four. The result was an across-the-board persecution of mutants that culminated with several massacres. To defend themselves, the mutant superhero teams X-Factor, the New Mutants, and the X-Men had to fight an astonishing array of merciless foes, including Apocalypse, the Right, and the ironically named Freedom Force. The heroes succeeded in defeating their enemies. But the greater battle remains the revocation of the cruel Mutant Registration Act. The enigmatic and incredibly powerful High Evolutionary believed that mankind's evolution was at a critical threshold, and that his opportunity to transform all mankind into mutants was now. Callously disregarding the pain, suffering, and devastation his efforts would cause, the High Evolutionary began to act. Earth's most powerful superheroes united to stop him. Though the High Evolutionary's overall plan was defeated, the legacy of his efforts continues to affect mankind. To escape his mystic exile and conquer Earth, which he had ruled before recorded history, the Demon Set enlisted the aid of the evil Atlanteans Lord Gower and Empress Lyra. To hide their conspiracy, the two undersea tyrants sent the armies of Atlantis to attack the surface world while they reassembled the Serpent Crown, an artifact of great magical power that could free Set. Earth's superheroes narrowly defeated the Atlantean hordes. But by then the heroes had to face Set himself. In the final battle, the heroes defeated Set and forced him back into his mystic prison. Led by Loki, the evil Norse god, Dr. Doom, the Red Skull, Magneto, the Kingpin, the Mandarin, and the Wizard conspired to destroy their superhero enemies. Their method trade enemies so that the superheroes would have to fight unfamiliar opponents. The plan almost worked, but the Avengers and their fellow superheroes rose to the challenge. Aided by a violent fallout among the conspirators, the superheroes triumphed over all who attacked them. The living, alien black costume that had once almost taken possession of Spider-Man was back. It had seized control of embittered newspaper reporter Eddie Brock and turned him into the villainous Venom. Now, it hungered for revenge against Spider-Man. Venom, who knew Spider-Man's secret identity of Peter Parker, began by terrorizing Parker's wife, Mary Jane. Then, the Norn boasted that Parker's elderly Aunt May was next. After a series of battles that only showed how unstoppable Venom was, Spider-Man used a last-ditch psychological trick that devastated the alien costume. Venom was defeated. The high-tech terrorist organization known as Hydra had launched a bid to seize control of the world. Led by Nick Fury, SHIELD, Supreme Headquarters International Espionage Law Enforcement Division, sent its agents, armed with some of the most advanced weapons in the world, against Hydra. Although SHIELD eventually triumphed, Hydra was not dead. In subsequent battles, Fury would discover the ominous truth of Hydra's motto: cut off an arm, and two more shall take its place. The mercenary spymaster had stolen the advanced Iron Man armor technology and sold its secrets to anyone who could meet his price. Among the buyers were some of Iron Man's bitterest enemies. Obsessed with the theft, Iron Man sacrificed everything, including his Avengers membership, in his quest to prevent all who had illegally purchased his technology from using it. After battling Beetle, Stilt Man, Controller, the Mandroids, the Guardsmen, and Firepower, he succeeded in repossessing all the technology. But the price he paid in lost friendships still haunts him. The hired killer Bushwhacker was on a non-stop mutant murdering spree. The mutant hero Wolverine was literally inches away from killing Bushwhacker when Daredevil interfered. Bushwhacker escaped but was quickly cornered. It was then that the manhunt turned into a desperate battle of reason versus passion for Daredevil. Wolverine had more than enough motive to want to see Bushwhacker dead. But Daredevil wanted to bring Bushwhacker to justice. Even though Bushwhacker, when faced with capture, demanded Wolverine's brand of justice, it was Daredevil who won. Bushwhacker went to prison. Daredevil and the Punisher were separately seeking Alfred Coppersmith, the murderer who had randomly spiked aspirin bottles with cyanide. The Punisher's brand of vigilante justice demanded that Coppersmith die for his crime. But Daredevil wanted to bring the murderer before a court of law. A rooftop battle between the two heroes ensued, with Coppersmith as witness. Ultimately, Daredevil won. Coppersmith was tried in court and imprisoned. The evil Green Goblin had a new plan to destroy Spider-Man. He would capture the Web Slinger and reveal his secret identity to the world. After trapping Peter Parker before he could change to Spider-Man and carrying him to his secret warehouse, the Goblin revealed his own identity. Parker was astonished the Green Goblin was Norman Osborn, his best friend's father. Peter managed to knock Osborn out, changed into Spider-Man, stripped the Green Goblin costume off Osborn, and carried the unconscious man out. When Osborn awoke, he had no memory of being the Green Goblin or of Spider-Man's secret identity. Craving enough power to destroy Spider-Man, the villainous Hobgoblin struck a deal with demons. But the demons gave Hobgoblin more than he bargained for. They turned him into a living, breathing monster. Blaming Spider-Man for his misfortune, Hobgoblin went on a berserk spree of destruction. Encountering his web-slinging enemy, the Hobgoblin savagely attacked. Finally, during their climactic battle in a sewer, Spider-Man took advantage of a fiery distraction to defeat Hobgoblin. The Hulk was on a rampage. Wolverine arrived and was ambushed by the Hulk. At first, Wolverine tried to reason with him. But the Hulk refused to listen. The result was a bloody, brutal battle that almost flattened a forest. Before even more destruction could occur, US government agent Clay Quatermain arrived and forcefully reminded the Hulk of their urgent secret mission to find missing gamma bombs. Thus the battle ended in a draw, with both combatants unhappy with the outcome. Spider-Man crossed paths with the Hulk while chasing Alpha and Charlie, members of the cyborg mercenary group called Warzone. Spider-Man's actions enraged the Hulk. Seeking to teach Spider-Man a lesson he'd never forget, the Hulk forced Spider-Man to fight him. The battle itself ended in a draw, but the Hulk accomplished his goal. He had taught Spider-Man a bitter lesson about how useless the power of a superhero can be. Wolverine had broken into the Adametco foundry in search of the killer robot, Tess-1. Captain America, also searching for Tess-1, found the quick-tempered Wolverine instead. Because of a misunderstanding, the two heroes became locked in a life-and-death battle, until Tess-1 launched a surprise attack. Captain America and Wolverine immediately set aside their differences and joined forces against the robot. As a team, they destroyed Tess-1. But with that done, the alliance ended and Wolverine disappeared into a forest. Thanos, the insane cosmic-powered being who worships death, had returned. Convinced that the Silver Surfer couldn't stop him, he arrogantly told the Surfer that he planned to present the lives of half the population of the known universe as an offering to his dark mistress. The battle between them raged across the universe. In the end, the Silver Surfer thought he had destroyed Thanos. But Thanos had used a double of himself to trick him, leaving the true Thanos free to complete his plan. The evil mutant known as Apocalypse had unleashed his death-dealing horsemen of war, famine, pestilence, and the Angel of Death on the citizens of New York City. He sought to sweep Earth clean of mankind so that mutants would be free to rule. X-Factor escaped from Apocalypse's prison platforms and counterattacked. For X-Factor, this battle was their last chance to save humanity. They not only triumphed, they also succeeded in seizing Apocalypse's incredible spaceship. And although Apocalypse escaped, X-Factor took comfort in knowing that mankind was saved. Using the newly enacted Mutant Registration Act and their own recent federal pardon as excuses for revenge, the evil Freedom Force staged a surprise attack on the heroic X-Men. The battle destroyed an entire city neighborhood. The X-Men suffered a crushing defeat. However, before Freedom Force could deliver a final, fatal blow to the X-Men, the San Francisco Police Department arrived and stopped them. Freedom Force left, determined to get a federal warrant that would legally seal the X-Men's fate. But before they could, the X-Men vanished. The mutant Morlocks had been massacred by the mutant-hating Marauders. Wolverine vowed to avenge their deaths and followed the Marauders' trail into the sewers. There, he was ambushed by Sabretooth. The battle was brutally brief, with Wolverine collapsing part of the sewer in front of Sabretooth. Soon after, Sabretooth staged an attack on the X-Mansion. He almost killed Wolverine's teammate, Psylocke. But Wolverine intervened. Wolverine and Sabretooth's subsequent battle took them over a steep cliff into the ocean. The battle continued underwater until only Wolverine surfaced. The X-Men were on a quest to find the dread psychic vampire, Sauron, and cure him of his curse, so that he would return to being a normal human, Karl Lykos. But once the X-Men followed him to the prehistoric savage land, they were captured by his mutates. Sauron planned to use the X-Men's mutant life energy to give him the power he needed to launch a worldwide campaign of conquest. The X-Men broke free, defeated Sauron, and, with their mentor Professor X's help, cured him of being Sauron. Titanium Man, the super-powered champion of the Soviet Union, challenged Iron Man to a duel. The Soviet super soldier's goals were simple: crush Iron Man, achieve a stunning propaganda victory for his government, and gain vast wealth, power, and glory for himself. However, Titanium Man's self-serving schemes came to naught, for, after an epic, globally televised battle, it was Iron Man who emerged victorious for all the world to see. In a bitter rivalry that has spanned centuries, these two half-brothers, the Norse deities Thor, god of thunder, and Loki, god of evil, have battled each other repeatedly. At times they have agreed to uneasy, temporary truces. But more often, their struggles have endangered Earth and the home of the gods, Asgard. Loki is willing to pay any price, short of destroying the universe, to eliminate his heroic sibling, and Thor will make any sacrifice to thwart his evil half-brother's latest sinister scheme. The Kree and the Skrulls, two alien civilizations, were locked in a war of annihilation, and Earth was caught in the middle. Despite the seemingly hopeless odds, the Avengers, Earth's greatest superheroes, were determined to protect their planet. By dividing their forces and attacking the battle fleets and home planets of both sides, the Avengers blunted the aliens' assault and turned back the invaders. In an awesome display of power and courage, the Avengers demonstrated that, as long as heroes like themselves lived to defend it, the Earth would be forever unconquerable. In this, the story that began the Marvel Age of Comics, scientist Reed Richards, his fiancée Sue Storm, her brother Johnny Storm, and test pilot Ben Grimm take off in Reed's specially designed rocket on an experimental space flight. But shortly after they reach outer space, the craft is bombarded by cosmic rays. The out-of-control rocket crash lands on Earth, where the four discover that, as a result of the rays, they now have superhuman powers. Reed Richards is now the elastic-bodied Mr. Fantastic, Sue Storm is the Invisible Girl, Johnny Storm is the Human Torch, and Ben Grimm is the super-strong, rock-like Thing. In their first battle, they save the entire surface world from the embittered ruler of the subterranean realm, the malevolent Mole Man. An awesome danger threatens the future of mankind, evil mutants. In response, Charles Xavier secretly forms the most unusual superhero team ever, the X-Men. At his own exclusive private school, Professor X, as he is known, recruits and trains the mutants known as the Beast, Angel, Iceman, Cyclops, and Marvel Girl for their roles as protectors of mankind. Their training is cut short when Magneto, the mad mutant master of magnetism, makes his first grab for world power. Magneto seizes control of the Cape Citadel missile base. On Professor X's orders, the X-Men fly to Cape Citadel and attack. Overcoming their youth and inexperience, they prevail. Cape Citadel is recaptured. But Magneto narrowly manages to escape. Despite that setback, Professor X proudly tells his team, "Well done." At a science demonstration, high school student Peter Parker is bitten by a radioactive spider. The results are amazing. Peter gains super strength, super agility, the ability to stick to walls, and an amazing danger warning spider sense. Planning to use his powers to earn money as an entertainer and support the people who raised him, his Aunt May and Uncle Ben, he designs web shooters and a costume and names himself Spider-Man. At his first TV appearance, he lets a thief escape, explaining that catching criminals is not his job. Tragedy strikes when several days later Peter arrives home to find that Uncle Ben has been murdered by a burglar. As Spider-Man, Peter catches the killer, only to discover that he's the very same thief whom he let escape days earlier. Realizing that with great power comes great responsibility, Spider-Man dedicates himself to a life of fighting crime as a superhero. In an effort to stop the flow of crack cocaine into the United States, the Punisher embarks on a plan that, if successful, would take him straight to the top drug overlord in Bolivia. First, the Punisher destroys a fortress-like crack house in New York City that belongs to the drug overlord. Then, he meets, is tortured by, and ultimately kills one of the drug overlord's top lieutenants. Throughout his bloody climb, the Punisher weaves a deception that, at the end of this issue, is about to net him his goal and audience with the drug overlord himself. Thin this story, which features the first appearance of the mighty Thor, Dr. Don Blake, while on vacation in Scandinavia, stumbles upon a secret invasion by the merciless Stone Men of Saturn. Attempting to escape, Dr. Blake falls into a cave and is trapped when its entrance collapses. Using an old cane that he finds in the cave, Dr. Blake tries and fails to pry his way free. Angrily, he strikes one of the rocks with the cane. A bolt of lightning splits the darkness, and Dr. Blake magically transforms into the legendary Norse god of thunder, Thor. With his cane now the fabled hammer Mjolnir, Thor bursts from the cave and attacks the alien invaders. So complete is Thor's victory that the terrified stone men vow never to return to Earth. This issue featured the dramatic debut of the Punisher. The supervillain known as the Jackal had tricked the Punisher into believing that Spider-Man was a supervillain who had to be killed. The Punisher succeeded in surprising, trapping, and, in what appeared to be a fall to the death, accidentally killing Spider-Man. But Spider-Man escaped and tracked the Punisher to his hideout. There he turned the tables on the Punisher and revealed to him how the Jackal had duped and double-crossed him. Furious, the Punisher disappeared into the city, having vowed to make the Jackal pay in full for using him as a pawn. The evil Norse god of mischief, Loki, seeks revenge against his half-brother, the mighty Thor. Loki chooses as his pawn the Incredible Hulk. At first it looks as if Loki's plot to use the Hulk to destroy Thor will succeed. But the combined intervention and powers of the heroes Iron Man, Ant-Man, and the Wasp expose Loki's treachery just in time. Together with Thor and the Hulk, they quickly defeat Loki. The success of their teamwork convinces the superheroes that they should combine to create a team that will protect the world against evil. Thus is created the Avengers. The tale opens with Peter Parker desperately trying to use his new Spider-Man powers to support his recently widowed Aunt May and himself. But his hopes are destroyed by the vicious editorial attacks of newspaper publisher J. Jonah Jameson. Not even after Spider-Man saves Jameson's son from certain death and stops the super spy known as the Chameleon does Jameson stop printing his demands for Spider-Man's imprisonment. The story ends on a soul-searing cliffhanger with the fear that Spider-Man will become mankind's ultimate menace. The original X-Men have disappeared. To rescue them and combat the increasing threat of evil mutants, Professor X desperately searches the world for good mutants to form a new team of X-Men. He finds them Wolverine, Nightcrawler, Sunfire, Colossus, Storm, Banshee, and Thunderbird. Along with Cyclops, the only remaining member of the original team, the new X-Men discover and free the original X-Men. The two groups then unite to attack the original X-Men's captor the awesome, gigantic evil mutant called Krakoa. After a spectacular battle, they defeat the monstrous menace, sending him away from the Earth forever. And in the wake of this victory, a new team of X-Men is born. The mutant hero Wolverine journeys to Japan to find Mariko, the woman he loves, but who unaccountably refuses to marry him. In doing so, he becomes a renegade who fights not only Mariko's husband and her father, but also the Japanese traditions of duty and honor. He refuses to bow to the crushing odds and to believe that he can never win back the woman he loves. Defeated in battle by Lord Shinjin, Mariko's father, he collapses. When he awakens, he finds himself in an alley in the Ginza district. So total is Wolverine's emotional and physical defeat that he doubts that he can survive the night in one of the most dangerous neighborhoods of Tokyo. The first appearance of Wolverine. The Hulk was in the middle of a battle against the terrifying man-monster Wendigo in the wilderness of Quebec. The Canadian government sent its superpowered agent, Wolverine, into the fray. His mission: apprehend the Hulk. But after he defeated Wendigo, Wolverine's attempt to capture the Hulk resulted in an even bigger battle that flattened the surrounding countryside. Despite Wolverine's best efforts, the Hulk won, knocking out Wolverine with a thunderous blow to the head. Wounded in Vietnam, payboy industrialist and inventor Anthony Stark is captured by communist soldiers and forced to work with the Vietnamese Professor Yinsen to create new weapons for the communist war effort. Instead, the two collaborate on the creation of a powerful suit of armor that will keep Stark's injured heart beating, prolonging his life. But when Professor Eanson is murdered by his communist masters, Stark uses the armor to avenge his friend's death and escape from Vietnam. In memory of the man who saved his life, Stark vows to continue to use the armor to battle evildoers as the superhero Iron Man. After being found frozen in a block of ice in the Arctic by the superhero team known as the Avengers, Captain America returns to the U.S.S.A. for the first time since the 1940s, and must come to grips with a modern world he doesn't understand. But his personal problems are put aside when he's forced to go into action to help the Avengers, who've been turned into stone statues by a marooned alien. Finally, after he rescues the Avengers, his newfound friends gratefully grant Captain America full membership into their team. Gaining their incredible powers from accidental exposure to cosmic rays while on a space mission, the Fantastic Four is without a doubt one of the greatest teams of superheroes ever. Many times the FF has selflessly saved mankind from supervillains bent on world conquest and aliens determined to destroy the Earth. Their adventures have taken them to other time periods, other dimensions, and even beyond the galaxy. Did you know the Fantastic Four is the only superhero team whose members' true identities are known to the public? The Avengers is the largest and most powerful superhero team on Earth. Its founding members were Thor, Iron Man, the Hulk, the Wasp, and Ant-Man. Today, over 40 superheroes are members, with most holding reserve status that places them on call in an emergency. In their long and distinguished career, the Avengers have fought menaces that include the evil Norse god Loki, conquest-minded alien races, and powerful supervillains of the past, present, and future. Did you know the Avengers is the first superhero team to be granted official government clearance by the National Security Council? The X-Men, a heroic group of super-powered mutants, were originally organized by the brilliant Professor X to defend mankind from the danger of evil mutants. The team's membership has constantly changed over the years. The heroes shown here form its latest roster. This group faces perhaps the greatest challenge ever encountered by the X-Men. Now they must not only defend mankind from evil mutants, they must also defend mutants from a mutant-hating mankind. Did you know, due to a mystic spell, the X-Men are undetectable by any kind of electronic equipment and cannot be photographed? The X-Men is a heroic group of super-powered mutants brought together by the brilliant Professor X to counteract the threat evil mutants pose to non-mutant humanity. Ironically, the very people the X-Men seek to protect often consider all mutants, good and evil, to be equally dangerous. In addition to evil mutants, some of the X-Men's greatest battles have been against unreasoning members of the human community. The team has had numerous members. Many consider the group depicted here, from a few years ago, to be its most powerful lineup. Did you know, as mutants, the X-Men did not acquire their superpowers, they were born with them. Cloak and Dagger are teenage vigilantes who use their mutant-based powers of darkness and light to protect children and teenagers, especially runaways, from drug dealers and other criminals. Though their quest to eliminate drug dealers has taken them to many nations, their main efforts are concentrated in New York City's Hell's Kitchen neighborhood. The personal cost of their efforts is high, for they have sacrificed any hope for a normal life in order to rid New York City of drugs. Did you know Dagger can use her light energy power to purge poisons out of a person's body? The New Mutants, a team of adolescent superpowered heroes, were brought together by Professor X, founder of the X-Men. Professor X's goals were to educate and assist the New Mutants in learning how to control their powers and use them to defend mankind from the threat of evil mutants. Now led by the mysterious cyborg, Cable, the New Mutants are learning how to cope in a world that has become even more vicious and intolerant of mutants. Did you know the punk-like hair strands on Warlock's head are really fiber-optic organs composed of living circuitry? X-Factor is a superheroic team whose stated purpose is to locate New Mutants and then teach them how to control their powers. Their task has become increasingly difficult because of the rampant anti-mutant hysteria sweeping the United States. But this hysteria has made X-Factor even more determined to help their fellow mutants. Ultimately, they hope mankind and mutantkind will be able to live together in peace. Did you know the founding members of X-Factor are also the original members of the X-Men? Great Britain's Excalibur is the greatest superhero team of Europe. Its members include the former X-Men Nightcrawler, Shadowcat and Phoenix, England's greatest superhero champion, Captain Britain, and the mutant changeling, Megan. Excalibur's adventures have brought them to several dimensions and many bizarrely different versions of our world. On many occasions, the team has prevented extra-dimensional super-powered menaces from conquering Earth. Did you know Excalibur travels from dimension to dimension in a railway train powered by a giant dragon? Led by Magneto, the Brotherhood of Evil Mutants is dedicated to overthrowing the governments of mankind and installing itself and fellow mutants who share its goals as the new rulers of Earth. Its greatest foe is the X-Men, the mutant superhero team that was created for the specific purpose of stopping the Brotherhood and other evil mutants. But Magneto believes it is his destiny to rule the Earth. And he will not rest until he has made his dream a brutal reality. Did you know Magneto once became an ally of the X-Men for several years before returning to his evil ways? The Sinister Six is an evil alliance formed for only one purpose: the destruction of Spider-Man. Composed of the web-slinger's greatest enemies, the Six have not yet been able to accomplish their grisly goal. Their suspicion and mistrust of each, although other, and each overwhelming desire to be the foe to deliver the final blow to Spidey have at critical moments turned Headquarters' secret certain victory into total defeat. Members undersea base, did you know the Sinister Six was the first group created by supervillains to defeat a superhero? The Hellfire Club is comprised of ultra-rich and powerful individuals whose ruling inner circle is engaged in a conspiracy to control the world through an interlocking combination of economic power and ruthless political domination. The inner circle was led by Sebastian Shaw, but Magneto, the mutant master of magnetism, deposed him and now directs the club's activities. Longtime foes of the X-Men, the Hellfire Club came close to destroying the mutant superhero team by turning the X-Men Phoenix into their pawn. This attempt, though, backfired disastrously. Yet this setback has not stopped the Hellfire Club from pursuing its plans to eliminate the X-Men. Did you know the Hellfire Club's inner circle is composed exclusively of evil mutants? Alpha Flight is Canada's greatest team of superheroes, and most controversial. Although created by its government to defend the nation, the group has repeatedly had to fight its creators just to remain in existence. Those battles seem to be over for now, allowing Alpha Flight to concentrate on what it does best: protecting Canada from all those who would threaten her, whether they be extra-dimensional aliens, supernatural monsters, or power-hungry supervillains. Did you know Wolverine was selected to be one of the first members of Alpha Flight, but left to join the X-Men instead? Created by some of the most talented artists in the comics biz, Stan Lee created virtually the entire Marvel Universe and revolutionized comic book writing as we know it today. Among the hordes of characters co-created by Stan are the Fantastic Four, Spider-Man, the Avengers, the Incredible Hulk, the X-Men, Thor, Doctor Strange. Heck, this card's not big enough to list them all. Did you know Stan's longest unbroken stint on any Marvel comic was on Fantastic Four, which he wrote for a whopping 114 issues, starting with number 1. Card front painting by Arnie Sawyer.